out before it gets any worse. Get clean. Call now and learn more. 877-247-1581. 877-247-1581. 877-247-1581.
Attention all business owners and creative minds. Do you need a unique and personalized touch for your products? Look no further than Romika Laser Engraving and Custom Designs. I'm Ron Phillips, co-owner of Romika Designs. We offer custom laser engraving services for a variety of products, including promotional items and corporate or personal gifts. With state-of-the-art equipment and a team of skilled designers, we can engrave intricate designs on virtually any material. Whether it's a special message, a company logo, or a custom design, Romika Laser Engraving will help you make your mark. And the best part, our prices are affordable and our turnaround time is quick.
I couldn't be happier with the work Romika Laser Engraving did for me. The engraving on my product was precise and exactly what I wanted.
So don't wait any longer to add a personal touch to your products. Call Romika Laser Engraving and Custom Designs today at 817-400-4040 or visit our website at romikadesigns.com. We look forward to helping you make your mark.
Hey, travelers, do you want to save money on your next flight? Then pick up the phone and call. That's right, call, because the best prices are not online. They're with SmartFares. See, SmartFares has special deals with the airlines. When they have unsold seats, they use SmartFares to fill them. So you get airline tickets at ridiculously low prices. Our prices are too low to publish online. With the extra money you'll save, you can book another trip or treat yourself to dinner or shopping. So stop searching all of those travel sites to find the lowest price on your next flight. Let one of our SmartFares expert travel agents find ridiculously low prices for you. Call SmartFares today and get the best price on your next flight. Guaranteed. Also, save up to 50% off business and first class tickets.
855-325-1820. 855-325-1820. That's 855-325-1820.
Have you ever met a single person in your life that enjoys paying taxes? No, no one does. If you can't sleep at night because you have a huge problem with the IRS, I've got some free advice for you. This service is strictly limited to individuals that owe the IRS $10,000 or more in back taxes. And if you qualify, we can guarantee that you won't be writing a big fat check to the IRS or our services cost you nothing. The first 100 people that call today will get a free tax consultation worth $500. Stop worrying about your IRS problem. We can help you, we promise. Call the tax doctor right now. I mean right now to learn more.
800-240-4587. 800-240-4587. 800-240-4587. That's 800-240-4587.
The voice of Johnson County, JOCO Community Radio.
Water. Top of the morning to ya. I love that song. It's so fun. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay.
Sorry.
Good morning. Good morning. Wake up to a brand new day this morning. It's funny when you turn it on, like, so I can like share the video. It's like, you hear my sound is still on a little bit, and so it's like, I hear me again.
Oh, gotcha. I was kind of confused where you're going with that. But.
No. So it's Talk About It Tuesday here at JOCO Vibes. Thanks for joining me, Anthony, Jared, Salazar, Tank, TJT Drama in the house.
I mean, there's a long list running. This
Hey, that's okay. I got a long list for me, too. I'm Sarah Reeves, Sarah Arden Reeves, Sarah Red, Reeves-Red. I don't know. You know, it's Talk About It Tuesday. I'm glad to be here. It's raining. I didn't know it was going to rain today, even though I looked at the weather yesterday, but I was looking at a different county.
It's all about work.
It was all about work. You know, I do that.
Sometimes.
Sometimes. I try. I like to work. So it's Tuesday and it's raining. It's spring. And it is a great day to be alive.
It is.
I like your purple. Fuchsia. Ultraviolet, maybe?
Hot
ultraviolet.
Pink.
No, because it's got too much purple in it. I think it's ultraviolet.
Pink. I get a lot of compliments in this shirt.
It's a good looking shirt.
I can pull off a pink shirt.
Well, you know.
It's from this new tan I got from the sun I got the other day.
Oh, from all those outdoor patios?
It's springtime.
It is springtime.
And it's, not so much today.
But it has been really nice out.
Except for the wind.
Yeah.
So windy.
Yeah, you were complaining about that last night.
Yeah, so windy. I mean, napkins are flying everywhere.
But at least it was blowing the humidity instead of keeping it stagnant.
Yep. I was told not to complain about the wind when it's 100 degrees outside and it's summertime in Texas.
Right. No, you're not allowed to do that. No,
I won't.
It's the fan blowing.
We need that.
We need that. And I need the rain to happen and feed the ground and then blow away with the wind so that I can go work.
Yeah, that's kind of important. Got to keep that money coming in.
Yeah, got to. It's struggle's real. I'm in oil and gas. I don't know if you know that, but that's, or if our listeners know that, but that's what I do. And I go survey out in the wilderness out in West Texas or wherever.
And you haven't been able to because your truck was down for like weeks.
It was two months, I think. One of my trucks was down. The other truck was down. Like, I still need a compressor, but they don't make them anymore. And, you know. It's awesome because I've got old equipment, but it would cost me way too much time, way more time and way more money to take all this equipment and put it on a different vehicle. And that would just be, I don't know how to do any of that, but I didn't know how to change out a radiator either.
I know. I'm impressed. You told me everything you did on this truck and I'm impressed. You are definitely more knowledgeable than I am when it comes to your truck.
Between me, YouTube and the Holy Ghost, we figured it out.
I mean, you can do anything on YouTube.
They have everything.
They do have everything.
In fact, I was talking to my associate yesterday, and I've got to learn how to work a new program. And he's like, well, you just pull up, just Google. There's going to be like 5 YouTube videos that you can pull up right off the top. And I'm like, oh, okay. Here I go again. YouTubing it. It's fine. It's wonderful. Because then you can I already know how to do that. Skip, skip, skip. At least you can do that. And you're not stuck in a class where you have to listen to it anyway.
This is true.
Yeah.
You're like, okay, don't want to listen to this person. Let's try the next person. This next person might be more entertaining.
Yeah. Kind of like defensive driving when you can go do that with the comedians.
I've never done defensive driving.
No?
Never.
I did it once when I was younger. And I was like, I couldn't get out of it.
I think I've gotten one speeding ticket in my entire life.
Oh, wow.
And that was going through Decatur, Jacksboro, or somewhere. It was like,
Decatur.
From 50 to like 35. Uh-huh. And I didn't see it at all.
It's Decatur.
Uh-huh. No, you know what? It was Bridgeport. I was going to Bridgeport. That's what it was.
Well, Decatur is a speed trap all the time. And they even have signs there. And like Waze is like automatically they have a cop on there. And what is that? It's a truck backing up in the parking lot.
I was
like,
that too.
What is happening right now? Is there a bomb going to go off?
But they're like, you can pay the ticket or you can fight it or, not come back here for 45 days. I go, I'm not coming back anytime soon.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure I can make that happen.
Right.
So I got,
I'll wait 3 months before I come back over. It'll be fine.
Yeah. I mean, I never go to Bridgeport. It's a one-time deal.
You know, it's like, I used to always get a ticket in Wichita Falls because they always have cops. They always got speed traps. And like every time you think you're not going to I think I'm good. Then there's a motorcycle cop and you got caught again. Yeah. But on 287, my brother lives in Colorado. So like that drive, 287, we make that drive a lot. And Memphis, they have a hide a cop. Memphis, Texas has a hide a cop on 287. But it's good. I'm glad I have a lead foot. I come by it natural. My father gave it to me and I can't help it.
I understand. I'm impressed. I've only had one ticket because I went to, out West Texas, Texas Tech, and that's a nice 4-hour drive.
Oh, yeah.
And to make that trip that many times and not get a ticket is pretty impressive.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of cops out there.
So.
So Mother's Day's coming up since we're talking about spring. And
I love Mother's Day, by the way.
Do you?
I'm a big mama's boy, so I love Mother's Day.
What do y'all do for Mother's Day?
You know, it's really, so here's the deal. And I'm not going to hijacked this with Father's Day, but it's real funny. I gotta make the comparison. It's always funny because, like, when it comes to Mother's Day, it's like, let's take the mom out and do this. When it's Father's Day, it's like, Dad, what are you cooking for Father's Day?
Yeah. Well, I mean, we got you a grill. Yeah, so
exactly.
Well, we got you an apron this year. So what are you cooking?
Yeah, no, I love Mother's Day. You know, moms in general, you guys are the best out there. You know, if it wasn't for y'all, you know.
So what do you do for Mother's Day usually?
You know, well, with my mom, I like to go see my mom, you know, flowers, brunch, or sometimes we'll do it on Saturday, so it's not as busy.
Right.
Do a dinner or a lunch or something like that.
It is the day to not go to a restaurant Sunday.
It is. It is. This is true. You know, I'll get with my sister and my father and be like, hey, you know, we're going to grill. We're going to do this. What do you want to do? I'm sure you know, it's funny because the ex-wife on Mother's Day is like, take the kids.
I just want peace.
I want peace and quiet.
let me have a day alone.
Exactly.
Well, what are you going to do this year?
You know, I haven't even thought about it, to be honest with you. I've been so busy. Until you texted me, like, hey, Mother's Day is May 11th. I was like, wow, that's like right around the corner.
Well, you know why I know this? Because my very hunky friend, Clayton Singleton, mm-hmm. we're going to give him a shout out. Let me see if I can tag him in this real quick. Clayton. Clayton is he's the founder of that Burleson Booze Viking Club.
Oh, that's right. Yes, you did send that to me.
Yeah. And so they're going to have their second or third, dad bod car wash on Mother's Day. So you can take your car, and it's a really good car wash because I did it last time.
Now, that's May 11th. So is that actually Mother's Day, or is May 12th Mother's Day?
Well, Mother's Day is always on a Sunday. So it's the Saturday of Mother's Day.
Okay.
But it's the day before Mother's Day, but you're going to do Mother's Day on Sunday, on Saturday. Yeah. So
I got to figure that out because, you know, there's a concert I want to go to in Waco, but I can still make both happen.
Well, you can at least get Anna to go through the car, give her some canned goods and some dollar bills and say,
happy Mother's Day.
Go through the car wash for the dad bod car wash. But it was funny because it was me and my dog Samson. He was in the front seat, and I had they ended up taking their shirts off in front of me, and one threw it on the windshield. And then I had a hairy chest on the right side and a hairy chest on the left side. And I am just in hysterics. It was the funniest thing ever. And they're wearing a lot of hot pants. You know, there were some unicorn pants and some American Eagle pants and I mean, tiny shorts.
Tiny shorts. Got it.
It was, and they're dad bods. I mean, Clayton works out a lot, but I mean, they're dad bods. It's hilarious. And
they're doing it for a good cause.
Yeah, I mean, they're raising money for the Harvest House. And that's what's most important.
Exactly.
And like at Christmas, Thanksgiving, I guess it was October, they did their, and you can donate money in canned goods at any time leading up to this they're definitely gearing up for it. And, you know, the Harvest House has been needing a lot more food lately. They've been running out. And at Thanksgiving, they were able to donate 6,900 and something pounds of food.
That's awesome.
So, and they take the money and they go shopping and they load up a trailer. They had to get a second trailer this last time and put more food in it because it got overweight. And so, you know, well, like
you got to applaud that. That's
awesome. They're really into supporting our community. And
it's hard times for everybody.
It is. So the Harvest House has said that statistics for the people that they're feeding right now. I mean, these people are making $100,000 a year, mm-hmm. and it's just not enough to cut it. Groceries are outrageous.
Yep.
Gas is high. I mean, everything's just high. Cost of living's through the roof.
I mean, gas went up like 20 cents just because of the eclipse.
Yeah. Well, it was like everybody's going to be in Burleson, Fort Worth, everything. Yeah. Let's go ahead and jack that shit up. Well, and then we have, you know, the war going on, and my associate yesterday said, well, I thought we were going to wake up this morning to $6 gas. I mean, you know, who knew? All the airstrikes and everything.
Yeah,
so
it could be
coming. It could be getting worse in the gas prices. So drill some wells. Call me up.
Yes.
Reeves, Sarah Arden at iCloud.com is 817-889-6744. I can survey your land and tell you where to find oil or gas.
Sarah would like to get out of Boston for a few days.
I would like to do some work. Maybe help our gas prices go down eventually. So,
well, let me ask you. So you're a mom. What are your plans for Mother's Day? And I know, you know, your mom.
Tiffany keeps making the chat overlay go away. Quit that. Good. I got it, Tiff. Thank you. She's working remote. But thanks, Anna, for joining. And Derek says, DJ T-Drama in the house.
Yes, in the house.
So we don't do a whole lot usually because, I mean, we just take it easy. You know, it's kind of like these days I like to tell people if it's their birthday, like happy birthday, I usually am like, I hope you have a peaceful day. You know, sometimes it's just better to just have some peace than have a wild raging time. I mean, I like to have a good time, but if at least it was peaceful, you know, that means you could be wild and it ended well.
I know a couple things about a wild time, so I get it.
Not TJ, DJ T drama.
Yep. Yeah. I'm known for a birthday spectacle once or twice.
And we've got that coming up.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm supposedly going to come out of retirement for that and bake a cake.
Oh, yes, he did say that.
But awesome. I got to know what the theme is. Where we're going to have that party at?
I mean,
where the party at?
It's probably a 3-day event.
DJ, isn't that a song?
Yep, that is a song. I think I played that over the weekend.
You did. It was a great time over at the Lumberyard, where the city has now approved their construction of a stage.
Yes, they are going to be working on an outdoor stage. So I know they're very happy over there. Something, you know, they tend to like to do a lot of live music.
Yeah.
And they do a lot of acoustic performances, some big acts, some small acts. But that's something they've been looking forward to. I know there's a couple of tribute bands that they're reaching out to.
One trying to get over here and shake some Burleson tail feathers.
Yep, something like that. One one that rhymes with Baylor. Whiffed.
So she could be called a meat packer.
Yeah. Yep. So they're really excited. You know, they've got the indoor stage where you can see me.
Mm-hmm. Wiki,
yeah. But no, so they're really excited about it, you know. So that got approved yesterday.
That's exciting.
Yep.
Yeah, I saw them walking back from City Hall.
But there's a lot of great stages in Burleson.
You know, yeah.
Heim has a beautiful stage upstairs.
I haven't been upstairs up there, but
there was not a band when I was playing, but they have a great stage. Station 330 has a great stage, brand new.
And you went over there the other day and ate.
Yeah.
It was
very good. I'm looking forward to going back. Didn't have one of their signature cocktails that day, but we'll definitely be having one of those.
I heard they had a lot of wait staff on duty, so they're trying to make sure everybody's taken care of, starting off on a good foot. Yeah. That's good.
Yeah. And then of course, you know, the brewery has their stage. I mean, everyone's got, like, you know,
yeah,
stages. And so
Burleson is becoming a music venue all in itself.
It is. You know, and I love live music and I love patios.
It's springtime. We gotta be on the patio. We only got like 3 months of good patios, didn't?
I know. Then it's so hot that you gotta sit in a pool or a lake.
Yeah, and we hope that the places that we're at have covers to keep the sun off of us.
Which actually, they just did install at Lumberyard all their umbrellas, which came in, which worked out great for them because it was funny because I was there and every time one umbrella popped up, people sat down at that table. You can't be in Texas in anywhere without some kind of shade coverage.
You know, I was sitting at the Spice Rack waiting, drinking my unsweet tea, waiting for Elise to be done with dance or whatever. And I was looking through the window and it looked like an orchard because they were all down and tied up and they kind of looked a little phallic. Derek, you have an orchard growing across the patio of white phallic
Objects. how do we keep this clean?
It's so Freudian.
Yes, you definitely made me aware of that last night.
I was like, hey, look out the window. You're like, what? I'm like, white? You're like, oh my God. Roger turns around. He goes, oh my God.
Some gestures may have been made after that. We'll keep that on the rest.
Oh, that was
good morning, peeps.
Good morning, Tiffany. Thanks for joining us from Florida.
I was trying not to annoy you with the screen, but I was trying to wait until all the previous chat stuff was gone. So,
well,
sorry.
It didn't go away until we got more comments, and I was there trying to read them.
Hang on, I'm trying to get to where you can hear me a little bit better. It's really windy here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. Can you hear us?
Hello.
It's not working. Can.
I was trying to switch to my headset, but it's not really letting me. So anyway, good morning. It is absolutely gorgeous here.
Where in Florida are you?
Nope, can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Is she in a tunnel?
Well, I thought she was on the beach. So, so she had a cousin's wedding. And so she went, she was able to go down there and and be in Florida on the beach for a few days.
I'm back.
I need some beach.
Yeah, and the internet sucks.
Somewhere. Well, we're glad to have you on the show, Tiffany. This is a bit.
Yeah, I just wanted to, I just wanted to jump in and say thanks for holding down the fort. And although it's a beautiful day here, I don't look like that, so I'm not sharing. So,
hey, Tiffany, where in Florida are you?
I am in Pensacola Beach.
Pensacola, never been there.
I lived here
on the map.
Pensacola? You don't know where Pensacola is?
Well, I'm sorry. I'm having a brain fart. Don't talk to me like I'm dumb. I'm just ignorant.
Okay, go.
It's early.
Okay, go. It's the Gulf Coast. It's Pensacola, Perdido so, Key, Navarre Beach, Fort Walton Beach, Destin, Sandestin. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you keep heading up the coast east. You get to Panama City, but this is white sugary sand, and
one of the beaches I actually have been to.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite places. So, anyway, congratulations to the lumberyard and getting a stage. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's there's a lot of places to go out here now, and the good thing is everyone's got their own variety of music, so it's something for everyone.
Yeah, like the brewery they do a lot of. They do country, sure, but they also do like that one band. I can't remember the name of it. Robin always knows, and she always pays attention. She's like, they're over there today, and they do a lot of Stevie Ray Vaughan. Mm-hmm. My mom loves that. So like I can even get my mom
dressed
and come out and come listen to Stevie Ray Vaughan. Cause that's, she still uses a CD player in the house and Blair Stevie Ray Vaughan, Ray Charles, all the, big heavy hitters like that. Cause that's, that's what I grew up listening to. Cause that's what my dad loved. Good old Stevie Ray Vaughan. Cause my dad called her Sweet Thing.
I know this last week in the station 330 had two bands I've never heard of. I didn't get a chance to get out there, but it's nice to see, just different bands in general and not the same one all the time. So, I'm a lover of music, live music, especially.
It's good. Oh, Robin comments. She was listening. She said it's Ashmore.
Yes,
they're called Ashmore. They're really good. they do them justice. So also this weekend is the Arts Festival in Fort Worth, Main Street Arts Festival. And that's going to be a good display of everything.
I love the Arts Festival.
Yeah?
I've been going there since I was 19 years old. Never missed it. Even when they had the tornado, because they moved it to 7th Street. I went to that. There's something about just walking around downtown on a beautiful day and with a cold drink in your hand. And listen to music.
Well, I've never gone as a grown-up where I was drinking, because I was... anyway.
I said I've been going since I was 19.
Yeah, well... I've been going since I was a kid, but not like regularly. Yeah. But it's as soon as I could start driving, I would drive me and my girlfriends to downtown, and we'd walk Sundance Square. And so whenever it was Arts Festival time, we were all there, and it was great. I bought my first piece of art there. I think I talked about this yesterday, but from the Milan Gallery, that's not there anymore. But that makes me sad.
Milan. Was a coach at my high school.
Really?
Yes. Can't remember what they coached though. Was it gymnastics? I cannot remember what it was. But yeah, so I didn't even know he's an artist. And then all of a sudden, someone's like, hey, coach, this was they have a gallery in Ford. It's like interesting.
I have, it's a 6x4 or something. Mm-hmm. And it's just a little impressionistic painting that is just beautiful to me. Yeah. And I paid $150 for that. And I'm like, it's on my wall in my bedroom.
there's lots of awesome art out there, all kinds of different. So, and I won't take up too much time, but one time I went and they had this thing called the Earth Harp or Wind Harp or something like this. So this lady was playing and it was hooked up to a building.
Oh,
that's how long the strings were. And it was amazing. It was one of the coolest things I've seen.
Wow.
Yeah. And so every year I'd go, I was hoping that she'd be back and I'd yet to see her again. I was like, that was pretty cool. Just the fact that they tied the strings to the building.
Wow. A lady that was one of my instructors when I was in massage school, her and her husband have a pottery studio. And they make like faces out of pottery, out of clay, and vases and mugs. And like they also make these things called rattles. And so there's like, it's an enclosed piece of pottery and then it's got like a little bead on the inside of it and it rattles. Mm-hmm. And so like I bought my daughter one once and they're at the Fort Worth Arts Festival usually every year. And it's a mermaid and it rattles and dirt on your skirt if you go out there, check out Dirk on your skirt. They'll probably have a booth set up somewhere. And that she was an amazing, amazing pottery person. And I don't know what they're called. If they have a label, I'm sure they do.
Plus, there's lots of good food out there.
Lots of food, food trucks, regular food, lots of different things to go and experience in Fort Worth in the Sundance Square.
The only downfall is, the parking. There's so many people out there.
Don't Sasha my downtown.
Yeah, that's the only.
Don't Sasha my Sundance.
Like only downfall.
Bless her heart. People want her to go back to Dallas.
Yeah.
She's married to Ed Bass.
Oh, I know. I got some inside information on that.
Oh, you did?
I'm going to keep that to myself, though.
Oh.
One of my best friends worked for them. And, yeah. not anybody happy in that group.
No.
At all.
No. That's why we have to pay to park.
Yeah. It's ridiculous. But I love downtown. It used to be my place to go.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, a lot of things are leaving there because of certain people.
Yeah, they're making life difficult on people.
Yeah.
But you know,
I mean, Riata's not going to be the same.
No,
that rooftop is gone.
It's not. Where are they going to go again?
Where did I just saw the update and I cannot remember where it's at. And I just saw it like 2 weeks ago. I was like, oh, that's where they're moving to.
We'll have to ask. We'll have to find that out for next. The Rustic has become a new hotspot in Fort Worth. Like, not the Rustic. What is it called?
Oh, the Rusty Nickel.
Rusty Nickel.
Yeah.
I keep saying the Rustic. I'm like, that's Dallas.
Huge patio.
Rusty Nickel.
Huge patio. Enjoy. And, you know, our very own buddy of ours, Aaron Copeland, will be playing there on Thursday with Josh Ward.
Yeah.
So we'll be going out and seeing him, you know.
But they've been having a lot of really cool artists out there, too.
Yeah, they're doing a music series for the next, I think, 4 or 5 weeks. So I'll be out there a few times on Thursday. Like I said, I love anywhere I can find live music, I'm going
to
go.
What was the event this weekend that I didn't get to make it to because I was at a dance convention?
That was the, and I still haven't gotten this name right. It's like the Smoke Show Syndicate.
Oh, yeah.
Like
Smoke Show Syndicate. Because I saw Big Associate Tim Philpott. He was out there with all his kids
down the stockyards.
Mm-hmm.
So it was fun. Like I said, good music. But I can't find bad music.
Well,
I did find one the other day. Someone allowed a guy to get on stage to play a song, and that was not a good choice.
They're like, no, I'm really good. I'm really good.
No, so no, that's what happened last Friday. Andrew Severner was playing at Spice Rack, and he was amazing. And I guess this guy thought he'd get on and play a song, so he let him and really butchered one of my favorite songs.
Oof.
Yeah.
Ow, that hurt.
Yeah. So,
you know, people do that with me whenever I get on the karaoke stage. They're like, oh, don't do that song. And I'm like, just wait. It'll be all right.
Here's the deal when it comes to karaoke. I'm not great at it, but I will put on a show.
Well, to make
you not realize how not good I am at singing. I mean, I will be the dancing chicken.
Well, you know, people always say, you know, don't ever do the Whitney Houston. I will always love you. I'm like, no, I'm going to do it every time. I'm going to do it every time and I'm going to nail it. And you're all going to be like, what? I'm like, yeah, I mean, I can do that. But you put Fancy on there, which I love Fancy, and people think I should be able to do Fancy, but I don't know the words.
Gotcha. My go-to song, and it's me and my best friend's go-to song. We do it, a duet.
A duet.
Is a Grounie County Auction. You know that song, right?
that's the one that's Hey John, Pretty Lady.
Yeah, John Michael. I mean, it is fast and
Hey Pretty Lady, won't you give me a sign? I'll give everything, make my no mind.
Yeah, you gotta take a big breath and
do your bidding, be your freaking call.
So you need your backup to cover.
My brother used to be an auto auctioneer. that was some of the funnest times in my life in the summer.
That's what I should do. Oh,
yeah. Man. Become an auctioneer. Yeah. You could sell a lot of cars.
Add it to the resume.
And we'll be back in a minute and a half or something, whatever the countdown is. And we'll talk some more. We got more stuff coming at you. Be right back.
Why have thousands of aspiring authors teamed up with Christian Faith Publishing to publish their book? Because Christian Faith Publishing is an author-friendly publisher who understands that your labor is more than just a book. We provide authors freedom and flexibility throughout the publishing process, professional book editing, award-winning design, and some of the highest royalty structures in the publishing industry. And as always, you will retain 100% of the rights to your book.
I was looking to find a company that I could trust, one that assisted in the editing process completely.
The most important qualities that I was looking for was a publisher who was honest and upfront, no hidden costs or fees, and owning the rights to my own work.
Christian Faith Publishing will publish, market, and sell your books in all major bookstores, online booksellers, as well as specialty Christian bookstores. Call for your free author submission kit.
800-978-4812. 800-978-4812. 800-978-4812. That's 800-978-4812.
Here's important new information from the Diabetes Solution Center for you, a family member, or a loved one suffering with diabetes. If you have lost your provider, or if you need a provider for diabetic supplies, you may qualify to receive your diabetic testing supplies now with little or no out-of-pocket cost, regardless of your age. All you need is Medicare or private insurance to be potentially eligible. Call the Diabetes Solution Center right now for details. Just takes a couple of minutes. Our friendly, knowledgeable agents will give you free, no-obligation information, handle all the insurance paperwork, and make sure your supplies are delivered directly to your door for free.
Call U.S. Medical Supply 24 hours a day. 800-597-9323. 800-597-9323. 800-597-9323. Call right now. 800-597-9323.
JOCO Community Radio. Listen live at tunein.com.
JOCO Community Radio is a member of EMG, a radio and podcast collective. Whoop, multitasking. Proudly serving communities like Johnson and Tarrant County, Texas, we are live 365 on the TuneIn Radio Network. And on our station app, check out our lineup and more at tuneinjoco.com. We thank our valued partners in helping us amplify the voices of our communities. You heard the commercials. Be sure to connect with Todd Hurd and Associates, attorneys at law. Use code JOCO2024 for 25% off your first order at thetiffy.com. And join Swipe Nation today and save on your credit card processing at swipenationusa.com, locally owned and operated. Reach out to Tiffany at jo.co@jococommunityradio.com for advertising rates as low as $50 a month. And we can make an advertisement program to work for you and your budget.
That's for you, Derek.
That's for you, Derek. We appreciate your support. So Dwayne Burns is proud to be a part of accomplishing the most significant conservative victories in Texas history. He's running for re-election in order to keep fighting to defend the unborn, to protect our children and local schools, and secure our border. He was happy to deliver the largest property tax cut in Texas history, over $18 billion to property taxpayers. Dwayne Burns grew up on the small farm along the Brazos River in southern Johnson County. He married his high school sweetheart, Jennifer, and together they have two sons and a daughter. They are members of the First Baptist Church of Cleburne, and he is one cool dude. He was in here. I was, thanks for sponsoring. He was in here for the mayor's show on Tuesdays. We have the mayor's show at 11. And he had him on, and I got to be in the room. I got to be on the show with him. And he is just a very genuine dude. And he's a good golfer. And so we got to talk golf. That was fun. And he's a rancher. So we got to talk about that too. And he really cares about the community. He does care about our borders. And he cares about our schools.
That's just true Texan right there.
That's true Texan. America.
America. Texas. Texas. I mean, you know, it's I don't know how many times I'm on Facebook or something like that, especially on the Burleson residence thing, and people are like, man, my property taxes. Man, yeah. My property taxes.
When, you know, people on fixed incomes, I mean, they, what are, how are they supposed to handle that? You know, like Social Security only comes in so much. And if, I mean, and that's if they can get Social Security, if they are, if they have retirement, that's amazing. But a lot of people don't.
Right.
So you can go out and vote May 28th. He's running in the runoff election between Helen Kerwin and, his sign's in my yard. And, you know, he goes, he's running for Johnson and Somerville County.
That's awesome. Got my vote.
He's a good dude.
I mean, pro-life, pro-gun.
Yeah. Yeah, all the things. Can't go wrong.
Two big topics for me.
Yeah, securing our border, making sure we have safe kids.
I mean, you look at, and I'll change it real, just, I won't take too much time on this. But like I saw, I guess, what's going on in Chicago, where there's a protest. Did you see this? A protest on the highway to get into, was it Chicago O'Hare? And people were actually walking out of their cars to get to their flats.
Wow. It's, I mean, I don't doubt it.
I mean, I mean, freedom of speech. I love it. You know, everyone has it. You can protest. Do it.
Right.
But don't keep other people hostage.
Right.
For your agenda.
What is that I posted the other day? Megan Hollowell says it, has said it to me almost 10 years ago. You can no longer allow yourself to be held captive by somebody else's crazy.
Right. And these people, and the thing is, and I saw a video clip, and there's not a lot of them, and the cops are just standing there. So, you know, it's coming from somewhere up top.
Right.
Let this, I mean, at some point, I'm surprised just people didn't rage and just drag these people off.
Fortunately, they didn't.
Right. The thing is, because, you know, what if you're on a flight to go see your dying mother or, you know, you got a family emergency, and these people, because they have, they have an agenda. They want to pretty much ruin your day.
I don't even know. What was it about? Do you know?
You know what? I can't. I was so irritated. I was like, I can't do this. I can't watch this. There's so much stuff on the news. I just can't even. I can't.
Right. I always have Fox 4 News comes on in the mornings on, like, it's my alarm in the mornings in my room. And so I get a little update, but it's the morning news. So it's lighter, you know, it's not so heavy and dark. And I like that. But I apparently have slept through that announcement talking about Chicago.
Yeah, I saw that yesterday. I was kind of like, what is going on here?
So we want to keep Texas a free state. And get things done for our people the way we know we want them done and protect our freedoms and liberties. So,
and the border.
And Dwayne is, he's definitely fighting to do that. Also, we have city elections coming up, and we have, there is Ronnie Johnson is no longer going to be on the city council. He's finally going to just take a break and do something else, I guess. I don't know. Thank you for your service, Ronnie. Thanks for always having Dairy Twin for as long as you did. they had chocolate soft serve ice cream, kind of like Bransom's, you know, like they had it before Bransom's had it.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Victoria Johnson in place one is running against Stephen McNally. He's trying to unseat her, I guess. Place three, Brandon Crisp and Alexa Bodecker, I'm saying it wrong because y'all said it 15 different ways the other day. Now I can't remember how to say it. And then that's for place three. And then place five is still Dan McClendon. I guess he's running unopposed. So that's what it says. 1, 3, and 5.
Get out there and vote.
Get out there and vote. I think that's coming up sooner than, I think that's sooner than the.
I think that's in May. I could be wrong.
You know, I don't remember, and I just clicked on it. But
I have the worst memory, so.
You can go to the Burleson City website and burlesontexas.com/elections, and it's May 4th, general election.
Oh, may the 4th be with you.
May the 4th be with you.
Wear your Star Wars outfits.
Yeah.
Go vote.
Nothing like fighting the darkness. I don't know. The dark side. It is the way.
It is the way. Go and vote.
It is the way.
Vote you shall.
You know, I'm not in the city limits anymore, but you are.
I am.
You should do that. You should
They've
go
yet to kick me out.
One day, maybe you'll run for office for city council.
That would be the goal.
Oh.
Wouldn't that be something?
We might have an in-house candidate.
I mean, if I lose, I lose. If I go down, I'm going down in flames.
So what would you run as? DJ T-Drama? Or would you run as Tank? Or would you run...
I think I'd run as Jared.
Jared.
Yeah, I'd go with the Jared.
Yeah. We'll have to say all the names, though. Yeah. The artist formerly known as Jared, formerly known as Anthony, formerly known as DJ T-Drama. That's funny. Well, I looked up where Riata is moving to, and they're moving. They're staying in downtown, but it's going to be a little bit further south west, and it's going to be where the old Cantina Laredo used to be.
And that's the bottom of the Bank One building, the one that got destroyed. I'm pretty sure.
Is it?
I'm pretty sure.
We'll have to figure that out. But my aunt was actually not at work that day when the tornado went through, but she worked in that. She worked for one of the big law offices in that building, and she just happened to not be at work that day.
What a crazy day.
Yeah. And like their floor was not in a good shape. So she said that is the original location of the Riata.
Oh.
Well, on their stuff it says the future October 23rd update, or October 18th, 2023, the update is they're going back to their old location.
I did not know that's where they were prior.
That's kind of cool. Cool. Awesome. What else do we know, Anthony? How was the singles event?
Oh, yes. The Broson singles event.
Where was it? Fort Worth?
I did a last minute DJ show for.
Yeah. And you're debuting for real debut. Oh,
This Saturday. Warning. I do have a golf tournament that Saturday morning.
Yeah. What are those been? You have two golf tournaments this week. One on Friday, one on Saturday, right?
One on Friday, one on Saturday. I'm not sure what the one on Friday is. I just got asked to play in it yesterday because of my great golfing skills that I have.
I can't believe nobody's put me on their team yet.
Which is not really that great. No.
Because I'm pretty good.
That's what you keep saying. We'll have to go play one day.
Yeah. I mean, I was an elk golfer. I was a lady elk golfer.
One day after the show, we'll go play.
Okay.
You know, there's two golf course riders.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can figure it out.
We left or right. Which way do we want to go? So the one I got invited to last night, I don't remember what it was. I was like, yeah, well, golf, I'm in. You know, who says no to golf? And the other one is this Saturday is at Hidden Creek. And it is all the proceeds benefit the Center for ASD. And that's just, you know, helping us special needs families.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure if there's any more spots open, but
they're still taking donations.
They are taking donations. And on what I have, you can contact Mac at 682-228-0925 to inquire about any spots if you would like to play. But I also heard it's supposed to rain this weekend.
Yeah, it is.
That's a damn
rain. Saturday looks like it's going to rain pretty good, like thunderstorms. But, I mean, you know, won't stop a good active golfer. Don't get struck by lightning.
I got a great the Thunder Rolls mashup I can play if it's thundering Saturday.
The Thunder Rolls.
Yeah, we can work that in.
It'll be a good time. Either way, it's going to be a good time.
Just hope it's not windy. If it's going to rain, don't be windy.
Well, whatever.
Be sunny.
Sometimes you want the wind to blow so it'll take your ball further, you know. Well,
yeah, no, for sure.
You just don't want to play into the wind.
Well, you know, it's crazy. So the Masters was this last week.
Yeah.
And they had.
And the winner is Scheffler.
Yeah, second win in the last 3 years. But I was watching it. It was so windy out there. When they were near the sand trap, the sand was actually hitting them in the face. You could see it. I go, what is going on? I mean, it's
wow.
Crazy. I'm surprised they didn't delay it or something like that. But it was crazy wind.
Well, they can't stop the freight train.
Cannot.
No turning back now. So that singles event, how was that? I know you were spectating because you were DJing, yes, so you didn't get to like participate, unfortunately.
Yes, I was very unsocial. But no, it was, I mean, it looked like it was a great turnout.
Yeah.
I know they, you know, they were at the Lumberyard and they also went to
Eagles Point. Do you think that they made a lot of great matches?
I'm not sure. I think they really enjoyed my DJing because a lot of them came back.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the only reason.
Yeah. Well, duh. Not for the ladies.
But no, it looked like they had a good turnout. I mean, everyone had a good time. So yeah, I'm sure they'll do it again.
Good. Well, maybe we need to have more singles events in all of downtown Fort Burleson.
Saw a few people out there that probably weren't out there being in it, but I think they were trying to be in it without being in it.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
They're like, I mean, I'm going to like stand here on the sideline. I'm going to be a wallflower.
Yeah.
And if it looks good enough, I might dip my toe in.
Yeah.
No, and maybe somebody will pull me over.
Because I'm DJing, so I'm watching. And I see a table of friends that I know, females. There's four of them. I see a couple gentlemen come talk to them. So, of course, I'm just kind of giggling to myself.
Yeah. I mean, you know, if you have not because you ask not, right?
That's right.
Like you want to try to get involved. And, you know, if like the Bible says, if you want to have friends, you got to be friendly.
That's right.
So if you want a mate, you got to try to find one. Like you got to say, I'm here. Look at me. I'm ready.
And it just seemed like it was more like, oh, it really was just a social event.
Yeah.
Not like a, oh, I'm here to come date somebody.
They didn't actually do the speed dating part.
No, that would have been great.
Oh, see, I want to go do that because I think that'd just be a fun experience.
It would.
And all the weird stories you could talk about. Like, you know what they just told me?
So it's funny.
Apparently they don't have a leg.
It's funny. I saw something, like I said, I don't watch the news very often, but I saw a clip and I may have been at the gym. And there was like a speed dating deal. And what they did is they brought in these inflatable tubs. And you were in your, you know, whatever you wanted to wear, but you were stuck in the water with the opposite sex and you got to know each other there. It was very odd. I think this was out in Dallas. It was very odd.
That's weird.
I was like, what is going on?
I'm going to say I'm not going to sign up for that one because I don't want to. Yeah. I mean, you never know what kind of people you're going to get. Mm-hmm. What if they pee in the pool?
That's true.
That's gross.
That's true.
Yeah, I couldn't do that one.
Well, you know, I'm a Friends.
It's the wrong kind of wet.
You know, I like Friends. You know, the show.
Took him a minute, guys.
Yeah.
So you're watching the show Look, Friends?
I'm Friends. I'm pretty sure it's Friends. I think Chandler has a third nipple on. Friends.
Oh, right. In so one of the episodes, he gets a third
that,
nipple.
If you do that, you already know that there's nipples out. You know, there's nothing to hide, nothing to be worried about.
Or something. I don't know. That's pretty awkward, Turtle. I couldn't do it. Again, wrong kind of wet. So there's also City of Joshua elections, and there are City of Alvarado elections, and we have the links in the comments section, so you can go look up those elections for your city and county, and go vote, make your voice known. You know, there was one election once where I had a house in town, but I was still registered to vote in at home at my parents' house, which is in the county. Well, at that moment, I actually changed my voter registration card so I could go vote for somebody to my house in town.
That's important.
I mean, it was important.
It really is. Know?
I mean, I'm living here. I might as well vote.
Now, so let me ask you a quick question. So 18, you can vote.
Okay.
Do you think you should be able to vote at 18 or should they raise that?
I mean, if you can serve in the military, you ought to be able to vote for who you're going to be serving, right?
I agree.
That's my one thing.
No, I completely get
but
that.
You can't smoke now. You can't buy cigarettes or nicotine anymore at 18. You have to be 21.
And that's kind of where I'm going with this. You know what I mean?
And you can't buy liquor.
I mean, I don't think you're really grown, you know, until at least 24. And some of us are still,
sure.
Some of us are still immature. I mean, some of us might be 43 and immature.
Right. 50.
You know. Oh, wait. I mean, 36 immature, not 43.
Right. No, me too.
But here's the other thing. You hear of all these stories about teachers influencing kids.
Right.
And, you know, so they're getting influenced a certain way when, you know, it might be not what their parents think. You know what I mean? So they got this agenda because there are people out there like, oh, you know what? I can push these kids a certain way, make them think a certain way.
Right.
Instead of just learning history or learning math, doing English, and it's like, I'm going to start pushing agendas.
We don't even have Walter Cronkite anymore, you know, because his job, he said, my job is just to present the news. Right. I'm just supposed to tell you what happened
right.
and what's coming, you know, like what's on the news, not give you my opinion, but we don't really have that much anymore,
right?
At all, if at all.
It's like, you know,
and so it starts there, and then now the teachers are just even, they're really bad in colleges these days. It seems like the stories that we hear from people and watching the people come out of school, and they're like, you don't even have a clue how the world really works.
Right. So they're kind of brainwashed. So yeah. Like, that's all I'm like, I mean, maybe it needs to be raised, but, you know, it's not my deal.
But at 18, like, if we can get them, if the parents are doing their job at home, when they're 18, their parents should have put a good head on their shoulders, right? Like, correct. That's, Elise is going to know how she ought to run, what direction she ought to go, and how she thinks, because I've done my job. You know, I have a friend that they don't want to teach their kid. They don't want to influence their kid one way or the other, let them come up with their own ideas. And I'm like, that's not really what we're supposed to do.
Right. Guide them.
We're supposed to guide our children and teach them.
Well, you know, my oldest daughter, she wanted to be vaccinated. I said, okay. No. I said, you're not getting vaccinated. I got a lot of friends that got vaccinated. They had to because of their jobs.
Right.
And, oh, look. Whereas, I mean, we're not still doing vaccinations and everything. Right. I mean, it's like, so you got this vaccination and then the world goes back to normal when you, because you didn't want to, you had to, and now you regret.
Right.
You know, it's not fair.
Right.
So, you know, but I was like, even, you know, Anna was like, nope.
Yeah.
You know, Anna had to get vaccinated because of her. She works in the medical field, which I understand, but it's still, you know, you're still putting something in your body that no one knew exactly what you're right. putting in your body.
And it's, you know, that's one of those things where you're like, okay, I think sometimes we have to just say, okay, I don't know. I'm not educated well enough to know what is right or wrong in this situation. So I have to rely on my faith at this point and say, if this is what I have to do so I can keep working and pay my bills and feed my family or whatever it is, then Lord God, I'm gonna pray that you're gonna like make sure that I don't get sicker because right. I did this vaccine, right. You know? And that's, you know, you have to rely on your faith, I think.
And there are people that lost their jobs because they didn't do it.
Right.
I mean, if you lost your job, you should be able to go back and get your job and sue for past, you know,
sure.
lost wages.
I think that some of them were trying to do that.
I mean, you should. I mean, I was like, okay, so now it's okay.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't you? Anyway, sorry about that.
Fight the fight.
Yeah.
Hey, man, that's why I supported Cuda Browns, because they were fighting the man.
Fight the man.
They did.
Damn the
They're
man.
Like, we're not shutting down. We're not going to shut down in this lockdown. You can't tell us no.
The man's always out to get you.
Yeah. So that was my first time going in there once, was during the pandemic, because I was like, I'm going to support you because
haven't there
fighting
been in there?
The man. Well, you just got to be ready to wash all your clothes when you leave.
So it's like a...
But they got voted best little bar in Fort Worth area.
Nice.
Yeah. Nice. By Fort Worth Star Telegram voters.
There's a few bars around here that I have to wash my clothes when I get home.
Mm-hmm. But Hooch is not one of them anymore.
Not anymore. They are smoke-free.
And it's amazing.
It is.
We just can't wait for Western Place and Cuda Browns to do that. But will they?
I don't think they will. You got to have that, you know.
They need that clientele.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong. Then there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, it's fine. I just know whenever I go in there, I'm going to have to wash everything.
You know, the thing is it's weird. The day I go to Western Place the most is on a Sunday night.
Sunday fun day.
Yeah, it's like, okay, how was your Sunday fun day? Well, I went to Western Place. Said enough.
Shot.
You dragged me in there actually recently.
And it was a damn good time.
It was a good time. From what I can recall.
You know, sometimes we just need to have our friends make us cut loose.
Yeah. It's nice to just wing it every now and then.
Yeah. Go for it. Grip it and rip it.
Grip it and rip it. Let the big dog eat.
Let the big dog
eat. You know what movie that's from?
No.
Tin Cup.
I was about to say it's a golf movie, but I can't remember.
Yeah.
It's
a good one. It's a classic.
I'm really itching to go play.
We'll set something up. This week is my first time to play all year long.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's I used to play a lot, but just haven't.
When my brother Derek was in town in November, we actually went and played, but we were only able to play six or nine holes because we were only able to play half because he got a call and he had to go to Weatherford to pick up some breakaway pieces, things, this little thing that, anyway, for a roper to, he had to go pick those up because somebody custom made them for him. So, nice. Like, okay, we got to go. Well, that's cool.
You know what's happening pretty soon is the Mavericks are in the playoffs pretty soon.
And the Stars.
And the Stars.
We won our division.
I know. I thought you said we were in first place.
Well, we won our division. Yeah, so we're first place on that in the division. And let's see. Let me just look at the statistics because I can't remember that stuff.
The Mavs are on fire right now.
So the Stars are number one in their division and number one in our conference. And we are number three in the league. So playoffs are starting. I just got a text message. Hello, Sarah. This is Justin with Conservative Texas Alliance.
Oh, I got a text alert from Cody Jinks.
You did?
Well, not necessarily him, just, you know, his spam room about talking about his concert coming up. So
tell me, what is that?
I don't know. I didn't
look it was one of those, update.
It's not local. I think he's here. I think he's here in August, though. But outdoor, you can't do outdoor concerts in Texas.
He can't, or
you can't. Was that Dos Equis in the house, whatever? 105 degrees.
Yeah, it's hot.
Yeah, no.
It's just hot and gross.
Yeah,
that's not fun.
And you have nowhere.
And you're in Dallas.
Yeah, and you're in Dallas.
First, you had to get there, and then you're gonna have to get back, and then you're gonna have to be there.
Right.
Nothing like
that. I can go any patio bar, and it can be hot, and that's fine because I can walk inside,
right,
and cool down,
right,
and come back.
And they usually have misters and
fresh
like
water that you don't have to pay for, mm-hmm, all that kind of good stuff.
Yeah,
and those concerts, they run out of water, and the water's hot all of a sudden.
Yeah, and so you're just baking.
That's the one thing bad about that festival we went to in Stockyards. Not enough beer tents. I mean,
really?
It was like 30 minute wait to get a drink.
Not enough pop up.
Yeah.
Bars.
No, not enough. 30 minutes to get away. At least 30 minutes to get a drink. And you know, I don't drink beer, and they didn't have anything I wanted, so I forced myself to drink one beer, and it was.
You don't drink beer at all. It's not your thing, huh? Mm-mm.
I'm a ranch water guy now.
Well, I mean, I know that, but you also drink the canned ones.
Yeah, I drink the canned ones or the tequila ones.
I like tequila.
Well, I like me some tequila. Don't get me wrong.
I can't do the canned ones.
You can't drink tequila all day. I mean, you can. I've done it.
I'm like, I'm sorry. What did you say?
You can. I've done
that. That doesn't compute.
But you know, when you're starting at 12 and you're ending at 2 in the morning, it's it goes off the track.
Well, you can't guzzle them. You just have to slowly drink.
But that's the thing. Those taste like water, though. Those,
yeah.
I mean, so it's really good. It's refreshing.
I know.
You know who has a very refreshing drink that I used to go to all the time is the brewery. They have all those Topo Chico drinks, and they have one. I can't remember what it's called. It tastes like a Dr. Pepper, though. And it is very, it's a nice summertime drink.
Yeah. What is it?
I don't know. It's got it's a Topo Chico with vanilla vodka and some black cherry Mio. But it's really, really good. It tastes like a Dr. Pepper.
Black cherry Mio.
Almost like a cherry Dr. Pepper.
Oh, okay.
But it's a nice refreshing drink. I have to go up there and get me one here pretty soon when it gets a little bit warmer.
Your face, you're getting excited thinking about it.
I was drinking that all the time, so I switched over to ranch waters.
Man, they're so good. Just not the can. So the canned ones give me a headache. Like, I can be like a drink into it, two drinks into it, and like automatic headache. Or any of the seltzers.
I feel great after drinking.
Unless it actually has alcohol, like liquor in it.
Right.
If it's just the regular kind, I can't do them.
I mean, I can't tell you last time I was like hungover because I drink ranch waters. I mean, I feel great every morning.
Well, I feel great every morning.
Matt will go run and work out like
because
it should,
I'm me.
You know what I mean.
Tank gets tanked up, and he still is. He wakes up and is feeling refreshed every morning.
I mean, you know, I mean, I got the call on Sunday, like, hey, it's 10 in the morning. I need you to DJ. I mean, I could sit on the bench.
Yeah,
you were
supposed to
the plate.
Be having a nap.
Yeah, I stepped up to the plate. You got to do that for your friends.
You got to do that for your friends.
Sacrifices. And not only did it for my 4 hours, I did it for six.
Well, and you were thinking maybe you might be able to get a date out of it because it was the singles event. I thought you were going to – I asked Derek, I said, did he get any numbers? And with all his newfound fame and power, he said, I don't think so, not yet. I said, well, you need to go hop him up. Anyway, we'll be back tomorrow and check out the rest of our shows. Thanks for tuning in to Sarah Red and Tank.
From Burleson to Venus and Grand View to Godley, this is the voice of Johnson County, JOCO Community Radio.
Let's be honest. Wheelchairs are heavy, bulky, and ugly. If you carry a wheelchair in your car to take care of a loved one, you know how hard it is getting that clunky, old-style wheelchair in and out of your car.